How's it going, guys? Watching Game of Thrones, Season 1, Episode 5. I apologize if you see any noise, any like static pixelation behind me or in the video we're watching. I've done my best to get rid of it. I think the lighting still isn't perfect on the green screen, but I'm trying. It's a skill I'm trying to develop. Hell, beginning of January, I didn't know the first thing about video editing. So it's been fun and a little frustrating. Speaking of the beginning of January when I started doing this, I didn't think by this point I would have 300 subscribers, but here we are. Owe that largely to the Game of Thrones community. I know you guys want to see somebody react to the show that you love. Happy to be doing so. I'm in a little bit of a unique position. I don't think there's that many people who haven't actually seen the show. I used to hear about it all the time at work and everywhere. And it was something that was trending. And because it was trending, I kind of was like, no, I don't want to watch it. Something about things that are popular with people, with most people, I'm like, no, I don't want anything to do with it. But I missed out on a good show, but now I get to share it with a lot of people. Also, I chose to watch The House of the Dragon, at least the first episode, before watching this. So gives me a little bit of a different position also. I'm looking for things that are also related to House of the Dragon. I don't know if it makes it any, enhances the experience or whatever, but it's just a different perspective, I guess. But again, 300 subs. Thank you guys. It's great to be doing this. Definitely a great hobby. Without further delay, let's get into the episode. Here's the man himself.
Does Sir Hugh have any family in the capital?
No.
I say there's no way he's alive. They're preparing him.
I stood vigil for him myself last night.
Bad luck for him, going against the mountain.
Who determines the draw?
Yeah, who says it's what?
All the knights draw straws, Lord Stark.
Aye. But who holds the straws? You've done good work, sisters.
My father once told me you were the best he'd ever seen. I never knew the man to be wrong about matters of combat.
He was a fine man, your father. What the Mad King did to him was a terrible crime.
That lad. He was a squire until a few months ago. How could he afford a new suit of armor?
Perhaps Lord Arryn left him some money. I hear the king wants to chance today.
Yes, that will never happen.
Robert tends to do what he wants.
Your mother was a dumb whore with a fat ass. Did you know that? Look at this idiot. One ball and no brains. He can't even put a man's armor on him properly.
You're too fat for your armor.
Fat? Fat, is it? Is that how you speak to your king?
Oh, it's funny, is it?
No, you're great.
No. You don't like the hands joke.
No matter what you do, you're going to be wrong.
You weren't the hand. The king's too fat for his armor. Go find the breastplate stretcher! Now!
The breastplate stretcher?
How long before he figures it out?
Maybe you should have one invented.
All right. You watch me out there. I still don't have a pointed lance.
I thought there'd be a breastplate stretcher too.
Why? Because I'm king? Piss on that. I want to hit somebody.
Enough of this.
Let's go watch him ride. At least I can smell someone else's blood.
Thank you, Sir Loras.
Now this guy's gonna go against him, huh? He doesn't seem scared at all. Definitely a better helm than the other guy had, though.
Such a shame, Littlefinger. Would have been so nice for you to have a friend.
And tell me, Lord Renly, when will you be having your friend?
I didn't get that exchange, to be honest. Damn, that's a big sword.
Stop this madness in the name of your... Let him go!
Sorry, loser. He still killed a kid for no reason, so...
Am I starting to make sense?
I think he's dead.
I'll be fine, my lady. There's no need to bloody yourself.
You first. You need a woman. Nothing like a woman after a fight.
Well, I'm willing if she is.
If the wrong ears heard what I'm about to tell you, off comes my head. You are the king's hand, and the king is a fool. Your friend I know, but a fool. And doomed unless you save him.
What sort of doom does the king face?
The same sort as John Arryn. The tears of Lys, they call it. A rare and costly thing. As clear and tasteless as water, it leaves no trace.
Wow.
Who gave it to him?
Some dear friend, no doubt, but which one?
If Sir Hugh poisoned him. Who paid Sir Hugh? Why kill him?
He started asking questions.
What you started doing as soon as you got there. Damn, a dragon head, a big dragon head, dragon skull. How'd that big thing get down there?
The fools tried to kill his son. What's worse? They botched it. The wolf and the lion will bit each other's throats. We will be at war soon, my friend.
What good is war now? We're not ready. If one hand can die, why not a second?
This hand is not the other.
We need time. Khal Drogo will not make his move until his son is born. You know what these savages are.
Delay, you say. Move fast, I reply. This is no longer a game for two players. It never was.
Tell me, does someone somewhere keep your balls in a little box? I've often wondered.
Do you know I have no idea where they are, and we had been so close. But enough about me. How have you been since we last saw each other?
Since you last saw me, or since I last saw you?
Now, the last time I saw you, you were talking to the hand of the king.
Saw me with your own eyes.
Eyes I own. Everyone's well aware of your enduring fondness for Lord Stark's wife. If the Lannisters were behind the attempt on the Stark boy's life, and it was discovered that you helped the Starks come to that conclusion,
I do believe that I have seen you even more recently than you have seen me.
Have you?
Yes. Earlier today, I distinctly recall seeing you talking to Lord Stark in his chambers.
What's that, you under the bed?
And not long after that, when I saw you escorting a certain foreign dignitary, council business. Of course, you would have friends from across the narrow sea. You're from there yourself, after all. We're friends, aren't we, Lord Varys? I'd like to think we are. So you can imagine my burden, wondering if the king might question my friend's sympathies. To stand at a crossroads where turning left means loyalty to a friend, turning right, loyalty to the realm.
Please.
To find myself in a position where a simple word to the king...
What are you two conspiring about? Well, whatever it is, you'd best hurry up.
Disturbing news from far away.
Dialogue.
Haven't you heard?
Off with you. No begging.
I'm not a beggar. I live here.
Do you want a smack on your ear to help you with your hearing?
I want to see my father.
I want to fight the Queen for all the good it does me.
You want your father, boy? He's lying on the floor of some tavern, getting pissed on by his friends.
My father is Hand of the King. I'm not a boy, I'm Arya Stark of Winterfell. And if you lay a hand on me, my father will have both your heads on spikes. Now, are you going to let me by, or do I need to smack you on the ear to help with your hearing?
You know I had half my guard searching for you. You promised me this would stop.
They said they were going to kill you.
Who did?
I didn't see them. But I think one was fat.
Better listen to your daughter.
They said you found the bastard and the wolves are fighting the lions and the savage. Something about the savage.
Where did you hear this?
In the dungeons, near the dragon skulls. You wouldn't let anyone kill him, would you?
No fear on that account, little lady.
Who's that guy? She's worried about.
Well,
I mean, he's got a weapon.
It's about your wife, my lord. She's taking the imp.
The earring. They say it's impregnable. Give me 10 good men and some climbing spikes. I'll impregnate the bitch.
I like you.
Lord Stark, your presence has been requested in the small council chamber. A meeting has been called.
I need to see the king.
Oh, it looks a lot darker and dingier in House of the Dragon.
Summoned you.
Is it about my wife?
No, my lord. I believe it concerns Daenerys Targaryen.
The whore is pregnant.
You're speaking of murdering a child.
I warned you this would happen back in the north. I warned you, but you didn't care to hear. Well, hear it now. I want him dead. Mother and child, both. And that fool Viserys as well. Is that plain enough for you? I want them both dead.
You'll dishonor yourself forever if you do this.
Honor? I've got 7 kingdoms to rule. 1 king, 7 kingdoms.
You bring us the whispers of a traitor, half a world away, and call it fact.
Jorah Mormont's a slaver, not a traitor. Small difference, I know, to an honorable man.
He broke the law, betrayed his family, fled our land. We commit murder on the word of this man.
And if he's right, if she has a son, a Targaryen at the head of a Dothraki army, what then? That's your wise advice. Do nothing till our enemies are on our shores. You're my counsel, counsel! Speak sense to this honorable fool.
I understand your misgivings, my lord. Truly, I do. It is a terrible thing we must consider, a vile thing. Yet we who presume to rule must sometimes do vile things for the good of the realm. Should the gods grant Daenerys a son, the realm will bleed.
I bear this girl no ill will, but should the Dothraki invade, how many innocents
I mean, where they're coming from?
Towns will burn.
Yeah.
Is it not wiser?
True.
Kinder, even, that she should die now, so that tens of thousands might live.
We should have had them both killed years ago.
I see what they're saying. I mean, from their point of view, it's definitely what should be done. Killing, I mean, some girl and a baby. But, I mean that's horrible. That's vile. But, I mean, back then, how many kids does it save? How many kids does it save in the future when the war comes? How many people, I mean, from their perspective? Of course, when they attacked with the rebellion, they weren't worried about innocent lives. So, but, I mean, it's all about perspective, I guess. What side are you on?
The Robert I grew up with didn't tremble at the shadow of an unborn child.
She dies.
I will have no part in it.
You're the king's hand, Lord Stark. You'll do as I command, or I'll find me a hand who will.
And good luck to him. I thought you were a better man.
Out. Out. Damn you. I've done with you. Go run back to Winterfell! I'll have your head on a spike!
Round up all the men we have and station them outside the guild's chambers. Who are your best two swords?
Heward and Will.
Find them and meet me at the stables.
It's not gonna stop the Kingsguard from getting in there if they want to.
You bring him here without permission. You pollute my home with his presence. Your aunt has done a bad thing, Robin, a very bad thing. You remember her, don't you? Isn't he beautiful? And strong, too. John knew it. His last words were, the seed is strong. He wanted everyone to know what a good, strong boy his son would grow up to be. He killed your father. He murdered the Hand of the King.
Oh, did I kill him, too? I've been a very busy man.
You will watch your tongue. These men are Knights of the Vale. Every one of them loved John Arryn. Every one of them would die for me.
If any harm comes to me, my brother Jaime will see that they do.
You can't hurt us! No one can hurt us yet! Tell him, Mummy! Tell him!
Shh. He's just trying to frighten us. Lannisters are all liars.
Ooh, I thought that no the Joffrey-Cersei relationship
Mommy?
Was...
I want to see the bad man fly.
Messed up.
Sleep good, little dwarf man.
It's a cell with a view. Wow.
I'm sorry your marriage to Ned Stark didn't work out. You seem so good together.
Glad I could do something to make you happy.
Without a hand, everything will fall to pieces.
The Targaryen girl convinces her horse lord husband to invade. And the Dothraki horde crosses the narrow sea. We won't be able to stop them.
Dothraki don't say. Every child knows that. They don't have discipline. They don't have armor. They don't have siege weapons.
It's a neat little trick you do. You move your lips and your father's voice comes out.
Is my father wrong?
Let's say Viserys Targaryen lands with 40,000 Dothraki screamers at his back. We hole up in our castles. Wise move. Only a fool would meet the Dothraki in an open field.
Oh, wow, he knows.
They leave us in our castles.
The other guy.
They go from town to town, looting and burning, killing every man who can't hide behind a stone wall, stealing all our crops and livestock, enslaving all our women and children. How long do the people of the Seven Kingdoms stand behind their absentee king? Which is the bigger number, 5 or 1?
5.
1. One army, a real army, united behind one leader with one purpose. Our purpose died with the Mad King. Now we've got as many armies as there are men with gold in their purse. And everybody wants something different. Your father wants to own the world. Ned Stark wants to run away and bury his head in the snow.
What do you want?
Just one.
I thought if I didn't talk about her, she'd just fade away for you. When I realized that wasn't going to happen, I refused to ask out of spite. I didn't want to give you the satisfaction of thinking I cared enough to ask. And eventually it became clear that my spite didn't mean anything to you. As far as I could tell, you actually enjoyed it.
I can't even remember what she looked like. I only know she was the one thing I ever wanted. Someone took her away from me. And seven kingdoms couldn't fill the hole she left behind.
Wow.
I felt something for you once, you know.
I know.
Was it ever possible for us? Was there ever a time, ever a moment?
No.
He's honest, if nothing else.
Does that make you feel better or worse?
Doesn't make me feel anything.
When John Arryn came to visit you, what did he want?
He wasn't that sort of man, my lord. He just wanted to know if the child was happy, healthy.
Looks healthy enough to me.
Can't imagine being without.
Girl should want for nothing.
One of my babies like that. Just, yeah.
Brothels make a much better investment than ships, I've found.
Good luck with my baby.
Oars rarely sink.
He was the king's hand. Perhaps Robert wanted them looked after. He was overcome with fatherly love.
Come.
Jory!
My lord. Stay back, sir. This is the hand of the king.
Was the hand of the king. I'm not sure what he is. Lord of somewhere very far away.
What's the meaning of this, Lannister?
Get back inside, where it's safe. I'm looking for my brother. You remember my brother, don't you, Lord Stark? Blonde hair, sharp tongue.
He was taken at my command. Answer for his crimes.
My lords! I'll bring the city watch.
Come, Stark. I'd rather you die sword in hand.
If you threaten my lord again...
As in, I'm going to open your lord from balls to brains and see what Starks are made of. My brother, Lord Stark, we want him back.
That's fucked. Oh shit, that's the end of the episode. Well, that's not the type of injury that you heal from fast. That went clean through his thigh, and not on an outer part, like right through the center, like making contact with the bone type of piercing. That's going to take a long time to heal from, and in reality, back then, probably would lead to massive infection, but that's rough. And he got piked in the back. Of course, Jamie wasn't happy about that, punched the guy out, but the end result is the same. Jamie wins, basically. Messed up situation. I can't believe Ned left like that, as in resigned from being the Hand. Robert, though kind of an asshole, as we've seen how he treats people. I mean, that's to be expected from a king. That's what I would expect a king to be like, kind of an eccentric type. You know, all about himself, like, I'm king. You know, that's how I would expect a king to act. But yeah, I can't believe he would just resign like that. Robert was a source of power and gave him the ability to do a lot of stuff that he normally wouldn't be able to do. Also, doing such a thing opens him up to danger from not only Robert being mad enough to send somebody to hurt him or his family, but, you know, anybody else that would want to hurt him or his family. It just doesn't seem like a good move, but I guess he puts honor above all. Not killing Daenerys Targaryen and her unborn child. I mean, I can see where they would be coming from when it comes to that, because if she convinces her Dothraki supreme leader that they should go across the Narrow Sea and fight them, then that would be a very bad thing for them. As King Robert said, he doesn't believe that they could win in a war against them. They could station themselves beyond the walls of the castle, which would be a good move, other than them enslaving and killing everybody beyond the walls and basically turning against the king and everybody inside the walls anyway, because they're getting killed and enslaved. So that's hell of a situation. Caitlin, I'm not sure how her name is pronounced. I just have it written down. Her sister is kind of not fully cooked, it seems like. That kid was like 10, 11, sitting there breastfeeding. And I thought the Cersei-Joffrey relationship was not good, but that one is, whew, that's real bad. I mean, I don't know. I'm not going to analyze that to death, but it's kind of messed up. That cell, though, that they threw Tyrion, I believe is how you say it, into, is pretty cool, though, the way it just opens up to the outside like that. Not cool for him, but I don't know. It's just a cool concept, I guess. Varys coming to Ned seemed to be I don't even know what he's trying to accomplish there. Maybe gain favor with him so that he can betray him, you know, the two-faced thing. But he was literally walking with whoever that other guy was talking about killing him, or killing the former Hand, talking about the wolf and the lion or something like that. I don't know what that's code name for. I mean, obviously people have code names around there. I'm guessing King Robert's the Lion. I don't know. So I'm interested to see what that is about. Underhanded stuff there. The guy who owns a brothel. I'm sorry, I don't know his name right now. He seems to be more of the on Ned's side, and even they exchanged some words, or he exchanged words with Varys until that other guy came in and interrupted them. So they're clearly, even though they're both on a small council against each other, it's just a mess of people against each other, betrayals and underhandedness. Nobody is united for the same cause when it comes to the leadership in that area, in the castle. The only other observation I can think of, I guess, is that the dog saved the one kid's life. He didn't want another death at the result of his brother. Probably, you know, bringing up feelings of when he was burned by his brother. Probably didn't do it for the kid, just did it because of his own feelings. I mean, you still don't redeem yourself for killing the butcher's boy, though. So, on to episode 6. I'm excited to watch it. Things really seem to be picking up. People are making moves. So, it's going to be interesting. Thanks for watching with me, guys. I'll see you in the next one.